peace I've come to know. Though my heart and flesh may fail, there's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well.
Good morning and welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. I'm Clint Davis, the church's pastor, and I'm delighted you're with us. I'm recording this morning from the back deck of my house overlooking the woods, and it's a wonderful setting on this beautiful spring morning to think about the conclusion to the Lord's Prayer. It's not actually a conclusion that we find in the Scriptures. Matthew chapter 6 doesn't include the phraseology we often use as we conclude the Lord's Prayer. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. But it is certainly a most appropriate way to conclude this beautiful prayer. In fact, it's an opportunity for us to conclude the prayer where we began. The prayer begins with, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. The idea of bringing glory to the name of God. As we conclude, we are ascribing glory to the name of God. We are elevating and exalting the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the great King, as we talk about his kingdom coming, for thine is the kingdom. It's an opportunity for us to once again be reminded of the fact that Jesus is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. He is the one who is worthy of glory, the only one worthy of glory. I'm not worthy of glory. You're not worthy of glory. Jesus is worthy of glory. Why? Because there is none greater. The most glorious one is the greatest one. And if the greatest one is the Lord Jesus, then he by definition is the most glorious one. And so we come to ascribe glory, for thine is the glory and the power. Jesus is all powerful. He is the one who is capable to accomplish all things that he chooses to accomplish. He is the Lord of glory, the Prince of Peace, the one who is full of power. And so as we conclude this prayer, we seal it with an amen. And that amen is a statement of let it be so. It's a statement of fact. It's a statement of affirmation. And it's also an opportunity for us to say that there is an eternal nature to the kingdom of God, to the glory of God, to the power of God. For thine is the kingdom, for thine is the glory, for thine is the power forever. It never ceases. My life is going to cease on this earth. Your life is going to cease on this earth. But God's life never ceases. And the beauty of the Christian faith and our hope in the gospel and the resurrection of Jesus is that while we are in the Lord Jesus Christ, we have eternal life. Outside of him, there will be no eternal life for us. So it is only in attachment to him through faith in the finished work of this cross that we can have eternal life and live forever. So Jesus is the one who is eternal and who is worthy of power, glory, and honor, both now and forevermore. As I conclude this morning, I just simply want to turn our attention to a hymn that is familiar to us, but a hymn that I think wonderfully sums up the sentiment of the conclusion of the Lord's Prayer. And it's a hymn that we know as All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. And it goes like this. All hail the power of Jesus' name. Let angels prostrate fall. Bring forth the royal diadem and crown him Lord of all. Bring forth the royal diadem and crown him Lord of all. Ye chosen seed of Israel's race, ye ransomed from the fall. Hail him who saves you by his grace and crown him Lord of all. Hail him who saves you by his grace and crown him Lord of all. Let every kindred and every tribe on this terrestrial ball to him all majesty ascribe and crown him Lord of all. To him all majesty ascribe and crown him Lord of all. Oh, that with yonder sacred throne we at his feet may fall, we'll join the everlasting song and crown him Lord of all. We'll join the everlasting song and crown him Lord of all. Friends, I want to encourage you to crown the Lord Jesus as Lord of all today. Let the day be a day where you ascribe to him all the kingdom, power, and glory that is due to him and to him alone. Have a great day, and may God bless you.
There's a peace I've come to know. Though my heart and flesh may fail, there's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well.